So, it took me about half an hour to assemble this caravan holiday thing, whatever you call that. So we're going to take a more in-depth look at what you get out of the main build, which is advertised on the front of the box. So we're going to take a look at our three figures first, as most would do. You get a little gentleman here. He got a Lego shirt on, apparently. And it's a double head, I think. I'm not sure. Yeah, it is a double head. All right, that's cool. And I think they all have double heads now that I think about it. So you got an older gentleman here. He's got a double head as well. And then you get the wife. Very cool. And then you get to build some animals in a tree. So you get to build a beaver. I like this. This is like really creative. That white thing is his teeth, and he's carrying a branch or something like that. And you got the tail that goes up and down. Like it. You get a skunk. His legs move a little bit. His head goes up and down. His tail goes up and down. That's cool. And then what I really like is this tree. Now, what they really thought about, and I mean they really thought about this, is they actually simulated the beaver chopping the tree down. That is like really creative. I mean, I would have never thought about that. That is really good engineering right there. I am not even lying. This is amazing. I love that tree. And then you get this picnic table. You got two mugs and a, is that like a water bottle or something? You got a fishing rod. Fish is just hovering in the air for whatever reason. Let's see if we can fix it. That looks better. And this is adjustable. Then you get a little cooktop with a pan. Looks like they're cooking something there. So that's cool. And now for the main attraction of this set. You get the van and the camper. So we're going to take a look at the van first. So the van consists of a paddleboard with an oar. I think that's what you call those. And it's a blue color. It's got a white stripe running across it. You get the license plate there. Grill and headlights. Everything sits flush with each other, so that's always good. Now, they added wipers. That's cool. And you got a stripe on the side and the wheels. These are new for 2020. Get mirrors. Mirrors are really cool. And then you get the back. I like the design of this. This is really creative. I love this. So, what you can do with this van, and there's a lot of stuff you can do with it, is you can open the doors up. Look inside there, it seats four figures, even though it's six studs wide, it seats four figures. And then in the center console, you get your controls for your windows and gear shift, I guess. And you get a steering wheel there. There's a gauge there, I'll show you that in a bit. But this seats four figures comfortably. And then the back of the trunk opens, which is also a really nice touch. So you grab this knob, the black knob here, and grab wherever you want. Try to pull it up. I don't even think it opens. Well, it does. There we go. And you can store a lot of stuff in there. Why is there like a jail cell? Why are there bars there? That doesn't make any sense. Is this like a prison van or something? I'm not sure what, but anyway, get the hitch for the camper trailer and get exhaust pipes and like the roof comes off. You gotta take the equipment off first though. That down there. Roof comes off. Better look inside. The gear shift is right there. Right there. Then there's the gauge right there, and then an AC thing or whatever it is, but some sort of a ventilation system. Very simple roof construction. The roof's been around for years. This white roof right here has been around for years. Get this back on there. Alrighty. So there is the van. Now let's take a look at the camper trailer, or a caravan as some call it. It's got these little legs that you can pull down. Right here, you just pull those down and it can stabilize itself. That's an extra piece. And then you got these little two storage compartments. And what was really weird is they put money in one of them and a camera. Well, that's normal, but why money in this? They literally thought to put money in there. Got a little step going up to the door. Does open like that. I'll show you that in a bit, the inside. And then you get... Now, I'll show you what this is all about in a minute. You got windows. And these are new windows. I've never had these. They're like flap-style windows. They open up. I'll show you that, too. Yeah, this is to open the side. Then you got a little ladder going under the roof. You get a little dish antenna thing, and it rotates. It's really stiff, so that's good. Oh, I broke it. Oops. I think that's intended to happen. I don't know. Then you get the skyline window there. That also opens up. Move around to the left. This window opens as well. It's got a nice color scheme. I love this. This is absolutely amazing. So there are two ways into this little trailer. One is you grab here and you pull, and it pops this open. What I like is there's a little locking mechanism that this interlocks with that, so it closes like that. So, well, I only have one complaint about this set, is why is there a window where somebody's taking a number two? Why is there a window there? I mean, you can clearly walk up to this window if you're like a passerby and just see someone taking a shit in this camper. I don't know what that's about. But yeah, the window opens. I don't know why they designed it like this, but it's fine. It's just a toy, of course. Yeah, there's a little sink in there, and there's the bathroom. There's a plunger on the right, toilet paper. New door frame. I've never had one of these. And close it up. So the other way is to actually take the roof off, which is the simplest in most cases for those people. And you get a little AC unit, and like I said, this window opens up. It's pretty cool. And this green thing, you're wondering what that is. Well, this is actually the awning. This is for the transport mode. So when it's not being coupled here, you can actually stow it here. That's what the instructions say. I'll show you. That's what the instructions say, stow it in there. But when you are using it, and this is to actually support the awning. You just clip it into these little things. Right here. Then you can use this little thing to adjust how high or low you want it. And that's really cool. And then this door opens up. Little steps. Here's the inside. The table and chairs fold up for easy stowage. So that's what I like about this, is that they actually thought about that. And it folds up. Save space. So you can get your little commode in there. That's what someone else calls it. And you get a little stove. Can't really operate it when there's the seat down, but that's fine. You get a little sink, you get a light. And you get some mail, you get a little light, and then you get a bed. The bed's pretty cool, I love that. Here's the bathroom a little more in depth. You just grab this... She can't even go to the bathroom when you're taking a little break in the sofa there. You open it up, and then there's your plunger. I like the way they did that. There's the bowl, and then there's the toilet paper. Over to the left, you get a little flower pot, and this window can open up, too, to allow some ventilation. So, not a bad build for the price I paid for it. I paid around $70 for this thing, but, you know, it is what it is. There's nothing wrong with it, no negative things about it, just despite that the window was right in the bathroom. Kind of like the vacation getaway set was the same kind of a situation, but... It's cool. I mean, for 2020, not a bad build at all. It's better than some of the other ones I've seen. I'm definitely keeping this in this kind of a state for quite a while. So, I'll just show you a brief look at the instructions. This set has, well, this build has 183 steps. And then here are just a few other builds. See, this is the LEGO Creator Expert. This is a LEGO Creator 3-in-1. See the difference? And I saw this at the store today. The 31109, the pirate ship. And that looks pretty cool. Is that like a... Oh, that's a mermaid right there. I love that. That's cool. And I love the sails. I love the design of those. It's like the wind's pushing them. You get some ghost thing up there. I love the skull right there. That's really cool. You get a shark. Looks like the shark's happy, apparently. I might have to get this. It was $100 when I saw it. Here's the Fiat 500, and all this is included, except for the background. And then here's the second build. I'll just briefly flip through the pages so you can see how to build it. Briefly.
Look at that. That's cool. I didn't know you made this. That's cool. Here's some of the other sets that they do make. So I have this one here. I have the 3104 and the 31101. I gotta get all of these except that one. I hate that one. I'm not getting it. And then here's some Technic sets here. There's the crane. I think that's for this year. I'll have to look into that. And if you don't know what this is a catamaran, just in case you're wondering. Here you get to build a lighthouse. So that's some of the stuff you get to do. A lot of cool stuff. I like the design of that. I'm going to have to build that sometime. Looks like they're just simulating waves. Something there. That's pretty cool. Let's see. I love this set. I mean, this set was really worth what I paid for. Now you can't really get in the lighthouse, but it's the thought that counts, and, let's see. Let's see what else we got in here. And it has about 271 pages. Copyright is 2020. If you guys really do want the set, it is available in my place. Well, in Oregon, there was only one of these left at the Target I went to. If for some reason your store does not carry these, or they are not out yet in your country or state, they do sell it on Amazon for roughly the same price. So, I mean, you guys really should get this set. I highly recommend you get this set, because not only do you get to build a lot of stuff, you can build other things with this. I mean, basically with any Lego set, you can do that, but this set is cool. You're going to do a lot more than just build one build and just call it a city thing. You're going to build two other builds, which is really nice. So, thank you for watching this video. Hopefully you guys enjoyed the video, and have a good day, everybody.